proclamation of the Word of God. Philippians chapter 3 and chapter 4, beginning verse 17. The reading: Brethren, join in following my example, and note those who so walk as you have asked for a pattern. For many walk of whom I have told you often, and now tell you even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ, whose end is destruction, whose God is in their belief, and whose glory is in their shame, who set their minds on earthly things. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly body, that it may be conformed to his glorious body, according to the working by which he is able to subdue all things to himself. Therefore, my beloved and longs for brethren, my joy and crown, you stand fast in the Lord, beloved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the sponsorial psalm. Our response: Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said to me, Let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet have been standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. Response: Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Jerusalem is built as a city that is compact together, where the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. Response: Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. To the testimony of Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. For thrones are set there for judgment, and thrones of the house of David. Response: Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Please be seated.
Please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke, chapter 16.
Glory
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We'll be reading from verse 1 to 8. He also said to his disciples, There was a certain rich man who had a steward, and an accusation was brought to him that this man was wasting his goods. So he called him and said to him, What is this I hear about you? Give an account of your stewardship, for you can no longer be steward. Then the steward said within himself, What shall I do? For my master is taking the stewardship away from me, and I cannot dig. I am ashamed to beg. I have resolved what to do, that when I am put away of the stewardship, they may receive me into their houses. So he called every one of his master's debtors to him, and said to the first, How much do you owe my master? And he said, 100 measure of oil. So he said to him, Take your bill, and sit down quickly, and write 50. Then he said to another, How much do you owe? So he said, 100 measures of wheat. And he said to him, Take your bill, and write 80. So the master commended the unjust steward, because he had dealt shrewdly. For the sons of this world are more shrewd in their generation than the sons of light. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. In our Gospel today, meron tayong parable. yung point ng parable is not just to tell a story. Merong point itong, merong punto na tinuturo sa parable. Sa parable natin ngayon, merong shrewd, merong, ang word dito is, yung steward, wasteful siya, no? So, tatanggalin na siya ng kanyang master. And so, yung steward, inisip niya kung anong, iniisip niya ngayon kung ano yung gagawin niya para sa future niya. And he dealt, yung pangit yung ginawa niya, no? Pangit yung dealing niya, hindi siya naging honest. Parang ninakaw niya, no? And this is worthy of, ano, pwede siyang mafailan ng kaso ng ano to, ano bang kaso yun? Kalimutan ko. Basta pwede siyang mafailan ng kaso sa ginawa niya. But the master commended the servant dahil he dealt shrewdly. No? Yung word natin ngayon is shrewd, shrewdly. Sa Latin translation niya, yung meaning nun is prudent. No? He dealt prudently. Actually, sa ibang translation, prudent yung word. And yung word na shrewd, meaning nag-isip, no? Nag-iisip kung ano yung gagawin. Naging matalino siya. And yung ginawa niya is for his advantage. Yun yung meaning ng shrewd. And yung prudent naman, it means may ginawa ka or iniisip mo or iniisip mo yung future, no? May ginawa ka at iniisip mo yung future mo and you care for the future, for your future. Yan yung prudent. During pandemic, kumuha ako ng ano, ng insurance dahil iniisip ko yung future ng family ko. Kasi what if kumawala agad ako dahil pandemic yun eh. So kumuha agad ako ng insurance during pandemic time, no? During wala akong kinikita, wala akong trabaho nun. Pero kumuha ako. Yun yung pagiging prudent. Now, dito sa gospel natin, sa parable, yung servant naging prudent siya kasi iniisip niya yung future. Ano mangyayari sa kanya? Pag tinanggal na siya ng kanyang master sa stewardship. Kaya ito yung mga ginawa niya. No? So yung question ngayon sa atin, anong ginagawa naman natin? Kasi darating tayo sa araw na haharap tayo sa judgment seat ng Panginoon. Hindi tayo forever dito sa mundo. Mamamatay tayo and we will face God. And ano yung isasagot natin pag may mga tinanong siya? Kaya isipin natin ngayon yung future. Be prudent. Isipin natin ano yung kailangan kong gawin para pagdating ng future, pagdating ng araw na yon, saan ba ako? Will I be with God? Or andun ako sa impyerno? Kaya be prudent. Isipin natin and gawa natin ng paraan na ma-secure natin yung future natin. Don't think of kung ano lang ngayon. Think of the future.